Here's Earth 100 years ago, and here's Earth now. In just one century, we've turned our planet's orbit into a metal minefield. A new study confirms satellites now appear in nearly every wide-field image from major observatories. As mega-constellations grow, astronomers warn this rising interference could disrupt future discoveries and long-term sky surveys. What's interesting is that we can't even see most of what's up there, and some satellites don't want to be seen at all. Today, we're diving into one of the most pressing issues facing both space exploration and astronomy, our increasingly crowded orbital neighborhood. We'll explore why our night sky is becoming a digital minefield for astronomers and the ingenious new method researchers have discovered to figure out what's really orbiting above us, even when satellites are deliberately trying to hide. Let's launch into it. There are currently over 11,000 active satellites orbiting Earth, with thousands more inactive ones creating a growing cloud of space debris. What's crazy is that we don't actually know what many of them are doing up there. Imagine if thousands of unmarked vehicles were driving through your neighborhood every day, and you had no idea who was driving them, where they were going, or what they were carrying. That's essentially what's happening 200 to 1200 miles above your head right now. The problem is getting worse, fast. Companies like SpaceX are launching what they call mega constellations, networks of hundreds or even thousands of satellites. Starlink alone plans to have over 40,000 satellites in orbit. That's more satellites than have ever been launched in human history, and they want to put them up in just the next few years. But here's where it gets really interesting and a bit concerning. Not all satellites are created equal, and some are deliberately designed to be as invisible as possible. Just like stealth fighters are designed to avoid radar, some satellites use similar techniques to stay hidden. They're built with special materials and shapes that minimize their radar cross-section, making them nearly invisible to traditional detection methods. So, how do you study something that's deliberately trying to hide from you? Traditional methods have serious limitations. Radar detection relies on satellites reflecting radio waves back to Earth, but stealth satellites can be designed to scatter those waves in different directions, making them appear much smaller than they actually are, or sometimes invisible altogether. Optical detection, basically trying to spot satellites by the sunlight they reflect, has its own problems. First, you can only do it during twilight when the satellite is lit by the sun, but your sky is dark. Second, satellites can be coated with materials that absorb light rather than reflect it. During the Cold War, both the US and Soviet Union launched classified reconnaissance satellites that were specifically designed to avoid detection. Some of these programs remained secret for decades. Even today, many countries operate satellites for military purposes, intelligence gathering, or communication that they prefer to keep under wraps. It's like a cosmic game of hide and seek, except the stakes involve national security and space dominance. So how do you catch a satellite that doesn't want to be caught? It's called stellar occultation, and it's one of the coolest techniques in modern astronomy. Let's say you're watching a movie on a screen, and someone walks in front of the projector. For just a moment, you see their silhouette perfectly outlined against the bright background. That's exactly what happens when a satellite passes between us and a background star. The satellite temporarily blocks the star's light, creating what astronomers call an occultation event. And here's the brilliant part. The exact way the star's light dims tells us the satellite's shape. Researchers at the University of Warwick have developed a method to analyze these occultations and determine whether a satellite has a box wing design, like most communication satellites with solar panels extending like wings, or a more compact square design. This technique is like astronomical forensics. Even if a satellite is coated in the most advanced stealth materials, even if it's designed to be radar invisible, it can't hide from this method because it literally has to block starlight to be detected. The researchers ran simulations with 100,000 virtual satellites to test their technique. They found they could successfully identify satellite shapes with impressive accuracy, essentially creating a cosmic fingerprinting system. But there's a catch, actually, several catches. First, the technical requirements are absolutely insane. To capture these occultation events, you need cameras that can take hundreds to thousands of frames per second. We're talking about satellites moving at 17,000 to 500 miles per hour, blocking starlight for just fractions of a second. Second, you need incredibly dense star fields, tens or even hundreds of background stars along the satellite's path, to have enough occultation events to work with. Most current telescope systems simply aren't fast enough or sensitive enough to make this practical. Third, and this is where it gets really tricky, this only works when the satellite is in shadow. If the satellite is reflecting sunlight, that light overwhelms the subtle changes in background star brightness. The technique is theoretically perfect, but practically challenging with today's technology. The researchers conclude that while their method is scientifically sound, it's currently beyond the scope of current optical observation systems. However, they're optimistic about future observatories that might make this technique routine. You might be wondering, why should we care about mysterious satellites and detection techniques? Well, the answer affects everyone who's ever looked up at the night sky in wonder. Astronomical surveys are being increasingly disrupted by satellite interference. The Vera Rubin Observatory, set to begin operation soon, expects that up to 30% of its images will be affected by satellite trails. That's like trying to read a book while someone randomly draws lines across the pages. This isn't just an inconvenience. It's potentially devastating for certain types of research. Long-term sky surveys that track changes in the universe over years or decades could be compromised. Searches for asteroids that might pose a threat to Earth could miss crucial objects. And here's something most people don't realize. We're not just talking about a few bright streaks across pretty pictures. Modern astronomy relies on detecting incredibly faint objects, galaxies billions of light years away, exoplanets orbiting other stars, gravitational wave events. Satellite interference can mask these signals entirely, but it's not all doom and gloom. Organizations like the International Astronomical Union are working with satellite operators to develop dark satellite technologies, satellites designed to minimize their interference with astronomical observations. So where does this leave us? We've transformed our planet's orbital environment in just one century, creating both incredible opportunities and unprecedented challenges. The stellar occultation technique we discussed represents the cutting edge of space situational awareness, our ability to understand and track what's in orbit around our planet. While it's not ready for prime time yet, it points toward a future where we might be able to identify and characterize any object in Earth orbit, regardless of whether it wants to be seen. This matters for national security, space traffic management, and preserving our ability to explore the cosmos. As we add thousands more satellites in the coming years, techniques like this will become not just useful, but essential. We're essentially learning to be detectives in our own cosmic neighborhood. 100 years ago, the space above Earth was empty except for the occasional meteor. Now it's a complex, crowded environment that we're still learning to navigate and understand. The next time you look up at the night sky, remember that you're not just seeing stars that are light years away. You're also looking through a layer of human technology that's constantly moving, changing, and evolving above your head. What do you think about this balance between technological progress and astronomical research? Should we prioritize satellite internet access for everyone on Earth, or preserving dark skies for scientific discovery? Let me know in the comments. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button and the notification bell. We've got more cosmic investigations coming your way. If you enjoyed this deep dive into orbital mysteries, you'll love our video on mini satellites, which you can find in the description below.